They presented me with their hallowed footwear. These shoes hurt because they're way too narrow. When I go in juvie, I got to wear them, or the kids say, Honeycutt, where's the kicks? See, I should never see a kid twice. They should get adjudicated and I should never see them, but I got recidivists. They're always there. And that's kind of good because I don't have to get to know them every time because there they are again. What'd you do this time? You know? My problem was I had one of me and I needed more me's. Once the guards trusted me that I could handle those kids, and I handled them with respect, not adversarial, you know, respect. There's two kinds of guards in juvie. There's a woman this tall. I love it when she's there. I can do anything when she's there, because she has a kind of respect with those kids. They will never cross her. You cross her, they'll all attack you. She has won their hearts. Then I got these other two guards. They're these guys, you know? They're adversarial. These kids, adversarial already didn't work with these kids. I can't do anything with them when these guys are there. I need them to just leave me alone. You know, I got this. So then they let me bring in my computer because they trusted me. You know what I did? I recorded 135 of my lessons. So I team teach with myself. I get archive Kevin teaching, and then I get time to mentor. I can walk around. See, I hated being an art teacher in that room, because art teachers, when you're demoing something, you gotta turn your back to them. You wanna do that in juvie? Or they're all gathered round, and you're in the middle of that big huddle. What's that smell like at 2:30 in the afternoon? Because they don't all shower, right? So suddenly I got Archive Kevin up there teaching the Fluffy Bunny lesson. Look at the Fluffy Bunnies. Gangbangers drew the Fluffy Bunnies. Look at them tough bunnies, man. One of the kids said, I'm giving mine to my mom. He still loves his mom. He's not lost yet. There's still time, you know. There's still a chance. I always believe there's still a chance, right? I treat the scariest kid in the room like he's the only one I trust. He's this big, man, he's huge. He's a dangerous kid. I said, man, you got my back this year? This is a tough room. He said, come again. Do you know me? I said, I feel like I know you. All right. So he helps me very loud. Shut up! Honeycutt is trying to teach. It's all you, Mr. H. This boy is my disciple now. All I did was believe in him. All I did is see the good side, you know? Now, I'm not stupid. I'm not a cockeyed optimist. I'm not a freshman. I know what he is. But how's he going to be what he's not if I don't see it? I'm going to will it to happen. I hired him to paint for me. Boy's 300 pounds. My ladder's rated to 200 pounds. He's two stories up, scraping the house in the hot Kansas sun. At 10 a.m., he's done. I'm done. This is crap. He climbs down the ladder, sits under the tree. He said, I'm going home. I said, have a nice walk. That truck don't leave to the end of the workday. Fine. He lays down. I started thinking, maybe just hot. So I got the hose. I just hosed him off. I felt like Greenpeace. You know, watch the blowhole. You know, he's got the thing going on there. He went, climbs back up the ladder, keeps scraping. Finish the day, finish the week, finish the summer. Started his own painting company the next summer. Went to JUCO, got his associate's degree. Guilted everyone in his family off the couch. That wasn't in Common Core. That was uncommon core, you know what I mean? That's the extra stuff we do, guys. We gotta talk about it. You don't have to use the real names. They gotta know how much we give. You know what I mean? They need to know that.